Everyone, Radianti here, and welcome to Let's Play World of Final Fantasy. So, this game just came out today on PC, and I generously received a code from Square Enix to cover it. So, let's do just that, and let us start a new game. And get on with this.
Prologue. Awake at last.
Tick-tock.
Rise and shine. Pretty high up. Pretty high up. So, one thing I should note with this game is I will be talking over cutscenes, but there's also subtitles, so. But I just need to put that disclaimer out there. Otherwise, how many people might complain? Don't fall. That would be bad. You're a little high up. You're really close to the edge.
Time to wake up.
What'd I say about don't fall? Welp. You're on the couch. Of course. Nice game console, though.
Oh, right. I gotta get to work.
Nice Moogle plushie as well. I want that plushie. Man. Be a pretty sweet plushie to have. That Moogle one?
Oh, am I gonna make it? The boss hates when I'm late.
Yeah. Well, let's just head for it.
And again, it's not like business has picked up any.
And just head for the star.
The streets sure are quiet today.
Seriously, really quiet. So luckily there are stars on the map to guide us on our path.
Here.
Hey, at least there's someone here.
How'd she get in if no one's here yet?
Good morning. I'm real sorry. I hope you haven't been waiting long.
Huh? Oh, she was daydreaming.
Right. She needs some water.
Oh, no thanks. A pint. I mean, a cup of coffee, please.
Oh, and bring the whole jar of sugar. I'm gonna need it.
Right. That's one cup of Joe. And I'll get you one of the big jars. Has nobody made the coffee yet? Come on, get it together, guys. I'm sorry, miss. This might take a while.
Hey, no hurry. Time's not an issue.
Oh, if you say so.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure.
How much sugar are we talking? Oh. Okay. Sure. Sure. That's a weird looking phone.
There you are! Mom!
Keep it down, Rain. About acting your age, huh?
Hey, don't talk down to me. Listen, last time I checked, little bro, I've been around a few minutes longer than you.
Oh.
Okay. I get it already.
Very sorry.
Reminds me of my mom and uncle.
I'm all ears.
Well, you don't have to get all sarcastic. You really are all ears.
What?
Forget it. Solon, have you seen anybody this morning?
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm looking right at you, aren't I? And there's that customer.
What?
Hi.
You didn't even see her? Dude.
Yeah, but... look! Come with me right now!
Easy!
You just see the water running? Doesn't seem like a wise thing to do. Just my opinion.
There's nobody here!
So, it's a quiet morning. Maybe they just...
I mean no one!
Huh?
Lon, have you bumped into anyone today besides her?
No.
Now that you mention it, I guess not.
And this isn't setting off any alarms?
Well, should it?
You two really don't remember a thing. Huh? What was that? Who are you? If you're from around town, then I don't know you.
Rain Manners.
You two really don't remember a thing. Would you please just answer my question? You can call me Anna Crow. Anna Crow will work.
Okay,
well, we woke up to a ghost town this morning. Maybe you know why? Yes, you're quite alone. But you always have been. Huh? This world, it's always been the two of you. A world without time. One that ended when it began.
What? That's the weirdest thing I've heard.
But don't worry. Just because the world ended doesn't mean that it's going anywhere.
What?
You know, I have been checking up on you two. Until now, you were nothing but blank stares. So imagine my surprise when Lon took my order. What a morning. Okay, now you're kind of scaring me. So, now that you're awake, we've got a story to tell.
Story time?
Which brings us to... Tama, right to here!
Hi!
Who the hog put this thing on my head?
Yeah, I did try to mention it before. You take it from here. I'll go on ahead and link up a path.
You the gun!
Huh? Hey, you can't just leave!
Or she can.
Salutations! The name is Tama, and I'm here to help out. Does anyone have any questions?
tons of questions.
Okay.
Why were you sitting on my head? And how long can a fox even talk?
That's the seriously the first thing on your mind?
Seriously.
Now I see why Anna Crow is just about the ready to throw in the towel.
You're not allowed to be confused.
Hey, whoa, take it easy there, Lon.
I thought you were upset,
Let's
too.
Let's start the over. I'll make us some of the coffee.
Huh? Oh, yes, please.
But I already had some coffee before you got here. How can you just roll with this rain?
Chill the owl. You'll live the much longer.
Yeah. You shouldn't start out your morning with so much stress.
Stress is bad for you.
Would you like some sugar?
Three cubes for you, right, Lon?
Huh?
I'm good with just one.
No.
Okay, I'll have to go and put the coffee on.
But I just said I...
You know what? Just give me my dang cup of coffee.
He's giving up.
Mirage Keepers? Me and Rain?
That's the correct. Those the marks on your arms are proof. You were born to work the miracles.
Miracles? Our arms can do that?
Dude.
How could you forget? You used to command a whole legion of them. You were masters of them. Powerful living illusions known as mirages.
Oh, hey. Masters,
fact,
huh?
Even the Pleiad answered to you, and those are the seven strongest mirages of all. With their power, you could have the ruled over all the world.
Oh. Sounds cool.
So, we could have ruled the world? Because, what, we controlled these mirages?
Well, that's what I've heard.
From who?
What do you mean? Anna Crow that told me, of course. But enough the reminiscing. I've got to teach you two to use mirages again.
What? How's that?
First off, I'm going to present you with my very own Prismarium.
Okay.
So what does it do?
With this Prismarium, the mirage inside becomes yours. And you can then make it do the anything and the everything you command.
Oh, cool.
So let's try it right now in glorious combat.
Wait, what? Huh?
That's battle time. All right, it is time to fight. Hey, it's that thing again.
Points, also known as AP. You automatically gain a little bit of AP each the time your turn comes around in battle. The amount of AP you need depends on the what you're trying to do, so make sure you use them wisely.
So AP is basically your MP of the game, but it does recover every turn, so that's useful. And the ATB of this is on the side. You will go up it along with your foes, and you can swap between who is ready. And this is for the basic menu. There's two menu options, basic and classic. I'll primarily be using classic just because I personally prefer it, but this with basic you can set shortcuts to use certain abilities, but there are a decent number of limitations. So let's go ahead and use Foxfire. Oh yeah. That took all my AP though.
Yeah, that's the way to do it.
That was all my AP. So yeah, you recover some each time and you will wanna try and watch out for what your enemies are weak to try and exploit it, because you can get some pretty cool benefits out of it, like, you know, doing more damage. Because they're weak to it. So you can speed up battle by pressing R1 or RB, depending on, you know, your controller. Let's do Libra on this thing. Sure, I'll check out some information. Unprisonable, nothing really interesting to say about it. Okay, fine. Let's just attack then. Go back to beating it up. So yeah, you can kind of see how, like, combat flows right now. Just, you wait for your turn, choose your ability, so on. You can speed it up. Like so, if you're impatient.
I knew that you had talent.
And this is explaining different battle modes, active, semi-active, and wait. I'm probably primarily going to be in wait. I might switch to semi-active for, like, some later parts. I don't know. We shall see. But wait lets you take your time in choosing things. And if active's too tough, you can, you know, you can swap it around. Anytime you can access the menu. And yep, so the classic battle menu is the only way you can access some commands such as items. Important to keep in mind because using items will be important as well. And you can pick and choose your targets when you're using the full menu. So classic menu is what I personally prefer to use. Go ahead and just finish this thing off.
Alright, alright. I think I've seen enough for one to tussle.
No trouble at all.
Alright. We did it. We are the masters. We get 7 gil for our efforts. We're rich. Oh, so very rich.
The figure it out yet? The two of you? We're undersurpassed. No, the Mirage could stand up to you.
Dude.
Oh.
Seriously?
Dude, this seriously.
It's hard to believe. I'm sure it is. As far as I can tell, you two have lost everything. All the memories and experience you've ever accumulated.
Ah, maybe too easy if we kept all our experience.
Wait. Of course that would have happened when you and this world were spliced out. Huh?
So not only did they lose the Mirages they had, they've been stripped of all their memories of the Mirages too? But I guess that explains why all their other memories seem to be largely unaffected.
What? Listen, let me show you something.
Okay. What do you want to show us now? Oh, it's a giant gateway.
There, just beyond this light, lies another world called Grimoire. That is where you'll find all the Mirages you've lost.
You mean they're all inside this gate?
You got it. Are you ready to conquer them again?
So, if we do manage to find all the lost Mirages, does that mean we'll be able to remember the things we forgot?
Well, I don't know about that. After all, you lost your memories. It's not the same thing as forgetting them.
Okay.
But, even if you don't remember Grimoire, Grimoire still knows a lot about you. You're certain to find traces and records of your past.
Okay. So, like...
You're saying... Whether we remember anything about ourselves or not, we can still find clues about our past and the things we've done?
Correct. And if you keep on gathering mirages, I think you might even meet your family in due time.
Oh.
Our family?
Huh? Well, I guess it does make sense that we'd have parents.
Well, duh. Oh, yes.
So then, you going? You going? Will you journey to Grimoire?
Okay. Dive in! Sure, let us save our progress. Sounds good to me.
Chapter 1. Land of the Lilikin.
Okay. Well, we... made it to the Wellspring Woods! Cool.
So, this must be Grimoire. What?
What? You look like such a little dweeb!
I know! We look ridiculous!
Huh? Oh, don't worry! I'm sure that's how every the body in this world must look. Inna Crow just wanted to make sure you had a nice and a handy way of blending in.
Oh, cool.
She can do stuff like that?
That is awesomely weird.
Well, this kind of works out. We won't have anybody gawking at our arms.
Way to find the silver lining.
So, we can freely change between the two forms, Giant and Lilikin, or Big and Small. Simply pressing LB plus B or X, depending on which character you want to swap over. Now, when you start combat, you'll go in as whatever current form you're in, so You'll kind of want to swap between them depending on what setup you want. And you can find more information in the tip jar.
I guess we should head straight down this path?
It's the only direction we can go. Think you can manage to not get lost? You know, just this once?
Mm. What? I'm not gonna get lost. Yet?
It's a straight path. We'll be fine.
Oh, hello. I spy another mirage.
Hi.
That is the call to Choco Chick. What are you the waiting for? Go on and imprison the it.
Okay.
Okay.
Away to you, too. So don't worry, we will not have to sit through this every single battle. That would make it extremely tedious. And make it take forever. Luckily, this is just for the tutorial. Alright, we are ready.
So what now? First,
ready for battle.
You're going to need this.
It looks sort of like a prismarium. What is it?
That's the call to prism. Use it to make the Choco Chick's prismarium. Every time you find a new of the mirage you haven't seen before, it'll be recorded in Enna Crow's special mirage manual.
Whoa! Does it even have pictures?
You the betcha. And whenever you add a new mirage to the manual, you receive one of its prisms. But only the first time, mind you. Okay, okay. First, try the weakening the Choco Chick, then the use your prism.
So, this is, to put it in Pokemon terms here, this is basically like catching a Pokemon. With a little twist. You only get one free prism or Pokeball or whatever you wish to call it, per monster, but each monster has a unique one. You'll get one each time you, or the first time you encounter a new one. So, that's handy. And, you know, you'll be able to find most every mirage you need. So, you know, lets you capture it and whatnot. But, so, start with Imprison. Imprison mirage turns into a prismarium, and that lets you use it in battle. If you fail, you do not lose it, so don't worry about wasting them. And you can find out information by pressing start. Libra will fill out more information for you. You can switch between them if there's multiple in a single fight, using LB and RB, and then different elements, as well as the different ailments and status symbols.
This is it!
So we're just gonna automatically use Libra here. So this is the Choco Chick. Choco Chick has a prism tunity of using a physical attack against it, so not too hard to get. Now you can kind of stack up the prism tunities.
There! A prism tunity! Use the imprism command to claim that mirage for your own. Go on! The select the imprism command. You might have to try different things before certain mirages will let down their guard and give you a chance to imprison them. Think the outside of the box.
So you can kind of stack them up till the maximum, which I believe this Choco Chick is currently at, to give yourself a higher chance of actually getting it onto your team. But they also, it doesn't last forever, and if it goes away, you have to re-trigger it. But remember, brute force isn't always the answer, so sometimes you have to put down the club, think outside the box, or think outside the club. Yeah. Anyway. Let's zoom up. Ow, he ran me. And use Imprison on the Choco Chick. You can also speed this up. Let's just there we go! We got a Choco Chick.
Hey then, look! You did it! Now that the Choco Chick is inside the Prismarium, it's yours to the keep!
Alright!
And we also level up, getting all money, just cheapskate. And we have befriended the new mirage, a little chocobo that loves to waddle around. These feathery friends love to headbutt things. This is fine though, because a chocobo's eggshell never cracks twice. We're just gonna use default names don't want to deal with naming.
Cool! I can see the Choco Chick running around in the Prismarium.
Pretty than neat, huh? Next, why the don't you have a go at stacking that Choco Chick on your head? Here, watch, I'll just show you.
Oh.
Oh, now I get it. So when I saw you perched on Lon's head back in Ninewood Hills, that's what you call stacking.
Yep, that's the right. While I'm up to here, I get to take it nice and the easy.
Oh, gee.
Is that stacking or slacking?
When you create a stack, the HP of everyone in the stack gets the added together. Like they say, strength in the numbers.
Oh, so it's like combining into a super robot.
Better than yet, your magic and other abilities have the potential to change too. It all depends on how your stack is configured.
Huh? Oh, I don't need any action figures when I get to blast out super attacks like a super robot.
Well, just be the careful. Stacking doesn't make you invincible. Some of the enemy attacks have the power to unstack you.
In other words, bye-bye super robot, so to speak.
Yowzers. It does sound like bad news.
It's true that we are individually the weaker when we're unstacked, but look on the bright side. Since we each get our own the turn in battle, we can use the extra moves to have one member attack and another the heal. It can be very the helpful. Depending on the situation, you might even decide to unstack yourselves by choice. Think the carefully and choose the best setup for the job.
So we'll get more into some of the ability combining and all that stuff later on. Right now, basics of doing stacks is you have a small, a medium, and a large. And you have to choose if you want to keep stack or want to stay unstacked. Just going to depend on the battle and your situation. And so, small Rain and Lawn are mediums. Big Rain and Lawn are, of course, larges. And you can only have one of each type in a stack, if I remember right. And small goes on top of the bigger. So, just remember that you need to watch how you stack them, and depending on, of course, how you stack them, like I said, we'll get more into this later. You can adjust some of your abilities and all that. Anyway,
You two can just switch between giant size and lilikin size. Depending on your size, you can make different stacks. You aren't be allowed to put big things on top of the small things when creating a stack.
How it goes, smush.
So, to get on top of a mirage, you need to be in lilikin form. The best way to learn is to try it once you've rounded up a few more mirages. You'll pick it up in no time.
Okay. What is this?
Huh? A dead end?
But there's nowhere else to go. What are we gonna do?
Never the fear! Look the closely! This may appear to be a wall, but it's actually a gimme golem.
Is this a mirage too?
Looks more like a cube
to
me.
Not in the traditional sense of the word. But you'll see these pests all over Grimoire.
Oh boy.
And unless you give them what they want, they'll give you a hard time and block the way.
So what is it they want?
It really depends on the gimme golem. So the first thing you'll have to do is examine it.
Alright, so what do you have to say for yourself?
Gimme, gimme!
You see a luster leaf reflected.
So where do we find that?
That Choco Chick you just imprisoned ought to be able to track the down what we need. But first things the first, you're going to have to unlock the right ability on the Choco Chick's the Mirage Board.
So, Mirage Boards are kind of like the Sphere Grid, the Crystarium, the Ascension Board from the mainline Final Fantasy, that is that sort of thing. Though it's a lot faster getting through them. So, you'll get SP or skill points when they level up. And this will let you progress through the board, get different abilities. And Stroll is the ability some of the smaller, I believe mostly smaller ones have. This will let you find random items in the field, and different mirages can find different things in different places. It's useful that I usually have someone with Stroll around. So let's go ahead and go to the Choco Chick. And let us learn Stroll. Now we also have 2 SP left, so I'm gonna go ahead and get Ram. Just to give it something to do. Let's swap over to Tama real quick. What do you got, Tama? You have HP, accuracy, strength. I like strength. I like hitting harder. Let's also go ahead and do stack setup. And adjust rain here and put the choco chick on their head. Now you can also go over here and do choco chick. And Tom is already on giant. So.
Hey, the choco chick's come along for a stroll.
Yay! Go over to this inconspicuous bush.
Huh? You found something.
Choco chick's like, hey! I found something!
Yay! You have found it! Now, try examining the gimme golem one more at a time.
Okay. Let's do that.
Gimme, gimme!
Sure. Have a left away.
Whoa! It vanished!
That's so cool! I guess the Choco Chick found us just the item we needed.
Hooray!
Yep, yep! With the help of a Mirage or the two, there's nothing that you can't accomplish. And Mirage boards are for much the more than unlocking abilities. You can also use them to change your Mirages into new and the powerful forms. So be sure to keep on the leveling up and working on your Mirage boards. Pretty soon, you'll be bouncing and the trouncing across Brimmoor like a pair of the pros.
So something to keep in mind with what Tom had just said there, with the you can go into new and powerful forms, it typically makes them different size, so you'll have to adjust your stack to compensate, basically, for that. But you can get more powerful and more abilities, and it's usually pretty handy to at least work through all of them, if you can. So let's just go over here real quick. Grab a chest with 3 potions. Aww,
so, Tama, I noticed mirages disappear when we defeat them. Why is that?
Most of the mirages you see in Grimmoor don't actually technically belong in this world.
Oh.
And so, when one of you guys gives them the old KO, they can't maintain their presence here anymore. They fizzle that out and go back to their own worlds.
Huh. Oh. I see.
Now, that's weird. Who was it that told me all this before? Ugh, it's like right there on the tip of my tongue.
So, one thing opening chests can do is it can interrupt little dialogue scenes like that, so I'll try to avoid not doing that. I might accidentally do it, just try to open a chest as I get to it automatically, just force of habit, but I'll try not to interrupt the talking scenes like that. Because they can easily get interrupted by doing actions like chess, menu.
Now what's this?
What is this?
This is the Cauda Murkrift. Inside you're the likely to find mirages that are, shall we say...
Mirages? Oh man, let's go catch them!
I don't like this. It seems like a bad idea.
This one's not very cute.
Actually, I think it's rather cute. So, Murkrifts are pretty scary. You really don't want to go into them when you first find them, because there's going to be pretty powerful enemies. But you can always go back later.
Mom,
take them out then.
Why did you... Now what do we do?
I tried to tell you. Inside Murkrifts, you're likely to find mirages that are the strong and dangerous.
You tried to tell us. Try a little harder, please.
Well, maybe if you had sat and listened. Gosh. Hey, we got empty prism though. Let's use Ram. Oh yeah. Oh, it missed. Let's use Libra. Oh yeah. We got this. Oh. Wait, we didn't get much information about it. It's large. It has some resistance to lightning and water, and not as much resistance against dark, it looks like. Okay. Ow. Ow. We got this, guys. We can do this. Alright, Tom, are you ready? Foxfire! Ow. Oh. Stop! see. Oh. Thanks, Lon!
Ow. Oh no. Did you two die already?
What? I died? But that's... no way!
Maybe it's true. That mirage in the Murkriff did kinda...
Well, I'm still alive.
Yes. That's because someone intervened. Right at the moment of your demise. And made it so the battle never happened.
Wow, you can really do that?
Of course. Although Tama's the one who does it.
That's the right! I have the power to rewind time a little. And then to whisk you to safety. Although, it cost me a life to do it, so I hope you don't mind if I rest for a little the while afterwards.
A life?
You might not believe it, but I've actually got multiple lives. Back there, I had to sacrifice one of those lives to turn back time and to save you. You see, this girl with the ribbon that showed up in my dreams, she's the one who taught me how to do it.
That makes zero sense and kind of freaks me out, but Tama, I'm impressed.
But thanks! Oh, but just so you know, I can only use my powers to protect the two of you specifically. And only if you lose a fight, like what happened to you in the Murkrift. Oh, yeah! And I can always recover my lives if you stay here and let me rest a spell. So, don't forget to give me a breather before I run out of second the chances.
Dude, you got it. Say no more. Rest yourself silly.
Yes, sir!
Thanks, Tama. We really owe you one. Especially Lon, who didn't have the good sense to listen before diving in.
Basically, barring basically big bosses, you can't really game over. You'll just be sent back to Ninewood Hills. And I guess, yeah, you'll be sent back to Ninewood Hills and you'll get back to where you were. But as I said, if you're in a threshold of powerful mirage, it's game over. Otherwise, you can't really game over.
Hey, who's that?
Oh, huh? If you mean our new guest, she claims to have gotten herself lost. Go say hello. She's quite the character.
Okay.
The real question is how she got here from the outside world when it's no easy trick. She must have experience crossing between planes.
Oh, okay. Well, we're gonna follow her next time. So, thank you all for watching. As I mentioned at the start, I did get a free code from Square Enix for coverage purposes and for doing this, so big thanks to them. And, of course, big thanks to my patrons as well, who help keep this channel going and my Let's Plays going. And if you'd like to support these Let's Plays, you can go support them on Patreon. Patrons do get early access to most, including my ongoing project of Nier Automata. You can also support the channel with Gothbox. And if you enjoy the video, you can like, comment, and subscribe down below. And finally, if you'd like to find me on social media, I am on Twitter, Facebook, as well as Twitch, where I stream 5 days a week. So thank you all for watching, and until next time, this is Rin Yun-T, signing out.